Hi everyone. Well, today I'm going to tell you the one of the main characters of Mahabharata, that is no other than King Duryodhan, Mano Govinda. You know very well that the Kauravas were defeated by Pandavas. And well, this Duryodhan, he was defeated by Pandavas because of his own misdeeds. And I will just give you a brief account of his mistakes, the what mistake he did because of which he was defeated by the Pandavas. Well, let me begin. The misdeeds of King Duryodhan and a few situations in Mahabharata. Let me begin from the not from the very beginning, but the beginning of war. Means when the war was announced, before that, both the side, Kauravas and Pandavas, they were preparing their armies. Means obviously when two sides were going to engage in a war, they had to collect the support of other kings. So thus both Pandavas and Kauravas, they sent their messenger to invite the kings from the different parts of the country. So when they called, they wished to call, invite Lord Krishna, means the Jaduchi, both Duryodhan and Arjun, they both went there. But you know what? Lord Krishna, as you know, he was the creator, he knew everything and he was always on the side of Dharma. He knew very well that Duryodhan and Arjun both will come to invite him. So he pretended that as if he was sleeping. So he lied down on his bed, just closing his eyes, but a beautiful mischievous smile on his lips. While he was sleeping, that time first Duryodhan reached there. He entered to his bedroom and he saw that Lord Krishna was sleeping. First he sat near the feet of Lord Krishna. But then, you know, Duryodhan was famous, was known as Mano Govinda. He had enough ego. So he thought that, why should I sit on the near his feet? Let me sit on the, being a king, let me sit on the upper side. That means where his head part was on the bed. So he sat there. Now, but he waited for Lord Krishna to get up, wake up. Now, after a while, Arjun came there. So when Arjun entered the room, he just sat near the feet. He thought that, let me sit here, because when Lord Krishna will wake up, I will invite him. He waited. You know, after a while, Lord Krishna woke up, and immediately he saw Arjun first. So he asked, "Oh Arjun, what's the matter? Why you are here? For what purpose you have come? And that to this time?" Then Arjun joined his hands, and at that time Duryodhan also indicated, he gave some gesture, made some sound that to make him know that he is also there. Now Lord Krishna looked at Duryodhan and he said, "Oh Duryodhan, you are also here? Well, tell me, both of you, why you have come?" Then Duryodhan told him that he has come to invite him for the war, to take their side. And when he asked Arjun, Arjun told him the same thing, that to ask his permission to take their side. Now Lord Krishna said, "Since I have seen Arjun first, let me give the choice to Arjun. So, oh Arjun, I have two things. One, I will give you Ayokshanis of, in one side, Ayokshanis of Narayani Sena, and the other side, I will be there, but I will not, means I will not fight for anyone. So, whom do you want? Then immediately, of course, Duryodhana was complaining that he should given the choice first. But as Lord Krishna said that I have seen Arjun first, he will ask me first. So thus Arjun joined his hands and very politely said, "Ki, O Lord, I want you. We all want that you should be on our side. Even if you will not fight, doesn't matter. Your presence is enough for us." And at the same time, Duryodhana thought, what a fool Arjun is, because Ayokshanis of Narayani Sena means they are just like powerful like Lord Krishna, and they are very good warriors. So he thought that, and he became very happy that, well, Arjun had chosen the wrong person. Well, this is his first mistake, that his ego only killed him and led him to do the wrong choice. But however, he had no option because Arjun had given the choice first. So he thought that what Krishna will do, after all, he was just a simple like cowherd and he will not fight. So the power of Ayokshanis of Narayani Sena is much better than Krishna himself. So this one is his first mistake. Well, the second is, when Lord Krishna went to Kaurava's assembly for a peace talk on behalf of King Yudhishthir, that time again Duryodhana misbehaved with Lord Krishna. Krishna didn't want this war, this bloodshed, this terrible battle between the cousins, and he knew very well that because of this, thousands and thousands of innocent people will die. But still then, he went there as a messenger and requested to stop this war. So he gave this proposal. Peace talk he did. But as I told you, Duryodhana was wicked-minded. He was cruel and cunning. And every time he was thinking the ill of Pandavas. So that is why he said that even the land on the tip of a needle, he is not going to spare. He is not going to give to Pandavas. They can only enjoy the land if they will win over them. So look, there is no doubt that the Kala, means the death, was inviting him. The destruction was inviting him so badly that he couldn't take a good choice, means a wise choice, he couldn't do it. And not only that, he insulted Lord Krishna, saying that you are a mere cowherd, and asked his soldiers to capture him, to seize him, which was strongly opposed by Pitamaha Bhishma and Dronacharya, Kripacharya, all other members. They told him not to do this, arrogant work. But Duryodhana didn't listen to anyone. And that time also, Lord Krishna smiled and showed his, he showed their Virat Rupa, not the Vishwa Rupa, but the Virat Rupa. However, this is the second mistake Duryodhana did. Well, before that, how he tried to kill all these Pandavas, that you know very well. So, one time even when, before this also he did so many mistakes. However, he then denied to give anything, and the war was fixed, and the battle started on a fixed day. Now look, what is the next mistake of Duryodhan? Now in the war, in the battlefield, Pitamaha Bhishma was the first, he became the Senapati of Kauravas. He fought as much as he could, though continuously he insisted Duryodhan to make, to be friend with the Pandavas and to give their Paitrika Sampatti. But that also Duryodhan didn't listen, and Pitamaha Bhishma was bound to fight against the Pandavas, which he didn't want, because he knew that where Krishna, there is the victory, and the Pandavas were the followers of dharma. Well, you know what? Even after doing so much, even sacrificing his life, his strength, his everything, he accused Pitamaha Bhishma with harsh words. One time even he told him so much, he used so much harsh words that Pitamaha Bhishma felt extremely sorry for that. And ultimately, out of anger, he said that, yes, I will kill tomorrow all the 5 Pandavas. So he showed him 5 arrows. He gave him. Actually, he kept it with him, 5 golden arrows. But that also, Duryodhan lost faith on him. And he told him, "Oh, Pitamaha, give me that thing. I will keep it. Tomorrow morning you will take it from me." When he said this, Bhishma knew what will be the consequence. He gave it to Duryodhan. Duryodhan took all the 5 golden arrows, which were, there was no doubt that those arrows would kill Pandavas. So Duryodhan took it and kept it with him. But as I told you, Duryodhan also had some good qualities. That means he was a very good friend of Karna. And he knew what is friendship. He never betrayed Karna at any time. And besides that, he also kept his word. Though he went for Ghosa Jatra just to see the fun of the misery of Pandavas, there he was captured by the Gandharvas. And when Gandharvas took him away, that time Arjuna was the only one who saved him. At that time, what good quality Duryodhan had, he promised Arjuna. When he asked Arjuna to ask him a boon as he was freed from Gandharvas by him only. He saved his life. And Arjuna told him, "Oh brother, now I don't want any boon. Keep it. Whenever I will need it, I will ask him." And when he kept these 5 golden arrows with him, that time Lord Krishna asked Arjuna to go and ask that boon which he had promised during the Ghosa Jatra period. And Arjuna and Lord Krishna, they both went to the tent of Duryodhan, and there they asked. When Duryodhan saw Arjuna, he asked, "Oh Arjuna, yes, what for you have come?" You know, at night there was no war, and they behave as usual, very nicely. So when he saw, he asked Arjuna, "For what reason he has come?" And Arjuna said, "Oh brother, give me that 5 golden arrows that Pitamaha Bhishma had given you." And Duryodhan was surprised. He was stunned and he couldn't believe his ears. Then he asked, "Oh Arjun, who told you about these 5 arrows?" "Now of course it is Lord Krishna. Who others could come to know?" But look, Duryodhan knew very well with these 5 arrows, all the Pandavas were going to die without any doubt. But he kept his word. He told him to give a boon, and at that time he gave all the 5 arrows. Arjuna took it, and both Krishna and Arjuna came back. Now he asked Pitamaha Bhishma to make it second time, But Pitamah Bhishma said, are you crazy? Have you lost your sense? This cannot be made for the second time. It is gone. So thus, what I am going to tell you, how he behaved with Pitamah Bhishma with cruel words, harsh words. Not only Pitamah Bhishma, even he used the same harsh words to his own Guru Dronacharya. That I am going to tell you. Okay, look, when after the fall of Pitamah Bhishma, Guru Dronacharya became the Senapati. Now Duryodhan, after his one day battle, war, he then came to when he saw that the Kauravas were, thousands of Kauravas, soldiers, the elephant, chariot, so many warriors, they were dead. That time, Duryodhan came to Guru Dronacharya and said, ki, O Gurudev, O Brahmin, I think you are not fighting with your full strength. And I know very well, said ki, O Brahmin, you live on our bread, but every time you have a soft heart for Pandavas. You want that Pandavas should not die. That is why you are not using your full strength, power. Otherwise, O Gurudev, is there anyone who can fight back with you and win over you when the weapons are on your hand? So, then that time also, Guru Dronacharya reminded him, ki, O Duryodhan, I told you 100 times that Nara and Narayana, they were no other than Lord Krishna and Arjuna. And Arjuna has already acquired all the divine weapon. How do you expect that anyone can win over Arjuna? He is invincible. I love him, there is no doubt. But that doesn't mean ki, while I am fighting, I am keeping some favor to any of the Pandavas. So thus, he told him and he felt extremely sorry. Just think about it. If a person accused to his elders, even after doing so much for him, is it good? Is it justice? So this injustice of Duryodhan, the behavior, the attitude of Duryodhan killed him. That is the reason why he was defeated by the Pandavas. And after hearing his harsh words, Dronacharya told him, ki, well, if you are telling me so much, then listen, I will give you a coat of mail, which even if Lord Shiva, Lord Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwar, or any other mighty person will come, nobody can do anything to you. No weapon will pierce through it. Just wear it and go and fight with Arjuna. But at that time, he told him when Arjuna took the oath to kill Jayadratha. That also, Duryodhan took the coat of mail, golden coat of mail, and wore it. That time he went ahead and went on shouting, screaming, and saying loudly, where is Arjuna? Come Arjuna, fight with me. Do a single combat. Not only Arjuna, he also called Lord Krishna. Thus he fought so badly, and Arjuna tried his best to release his arrow on him, but not a single arrow struck, pierced through his golden coat of mail. And when nothing worked out, that time Lord Krishna was also surprised. He was stunned. He said, Oh Arjuna, what type of fight you are doing now? Have you lost your strength? Is there no strength in your bow, Gandivadhanu? Or you have forgotten the mantras, chanting? What happened? What is wrong? Then Arjuna said, Oh Lord, Oh Kesava, you know everything. Why you are asking me? You know why I cannot do anything to him. Oh Lord, you are the Lord of this universe. You are in everybody's heart, but still you are showing as if you don't know. Well, this is only because of the Guru Dronacharya. The armor he has given to Duryodhan, nobody in this universe can pierce through it. Nobody can harm him now. So he looked at the part of Duryodhana's body where he could pierce his arrow. At that time, he could only see the part where the armor didn't cover, that was his palms. So he shot the arrow to his palms and it pierced through that. But while he was taking the Vyastra, that time Aswastama from the backside cut it down. And now Arjun didn't try to follow more to Duryodhana, rather to follow to Jayadratha, because the sun was on the going to set on the west side. So Lord Krishna moved the chariot as fast as it could be. Well, there are so many incidents by which Duryodhana brought his own downfall. Now let me tell you this much, and once again I will tell you the other incidents. But by the way, his good side is that there is no doubt that he was a very good friend, and he kept his words, and that too he always preferred to help his own brothers and other relatives, though he was an enemy of Pandavas. Thank you so much. Once again, I will meet you with some other part of Mahabharata. Thank you. And yes, if you have time, please visit my site, thegalpa.com. Thank you.